again, welcome everybody to our service this morning, this bank holiday weekend. Just got a couple of notices. Firstly, next Sunday, the morning service is Holy Communion, but with Holy Baptism. So we'll be baptizing Theodore into the family of the church in the course of the morning service. And then at 3 o'clock in the afternoon, there is our animal service, when people can bring pets to be blessed. And that's actually going to be live-streamed by the diocese as part of their series of multilingual services for non-English-speaking Anglicans. So it won't affect us. We'll go out over subtitles for those who don't follow English terribly well. Which is rather nice that they've chosen us for this occasion. My other notice is I published the banns of marriage between Sarah Alice Jenkinson, single person of this parish, and Andrew Michael McLean, single person, also of this parish, but both with a demonstrable connection to St. Mary Magdalene Clitheroe. This is for the first time of asking. If any of you know any cause or just impediment why these persons may not be joined together in holy matrimony, you should now declare it. Please remember Sarah and Andrew in your prayers as they prepare their marriage, which I think has been under preparation, shall we say, or planned since sometime last year when COVID ensued. But so it'll be the end of a long period of preparation for them. Today is the 13th Sunday after Trinity. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
We say together, Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. As we prepare to share in this holy sacrament, let us pause, call to mind our sins, and come to God, trusting in his mercy and his forgiveness, and not in any goodness of our own. Lord, we have sinned in thought, word, and deed, and in the good we have not done. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
We have not loved you in all our hearts. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves.
Lord,
have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Almighty God, forgive all who truly repent. Have mercy upon you. Pardon and deliver you from all your sins. Confirm and strengthen you in all goodness. And keep in life eternal, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Now, as God's beloved and forgiven people, we stand to say the Glory in Excelsis together. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth. Lord God, Heavenly King, Almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Almighty God, who called your church to bear witness that you were in Christ reconciling the world to yourself, help us to proclaim the good news of your love, that all who hear it may be drawn to you, through him who was lifted up on the cross and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen. Amen.
Please sit for our confession.
Reading from the letter of James. Every generous act of giving, with every perfect gift, is from above, coming down from the Father of lights, with whom there is no variation or shadow due to change. In fulfillment of his own purpose, he gave us birth by the word of truth, so that we would become a kind of first fruits of his creatures. You must understand this, my beloved. Let everyone be quick to listen, slow to speak, slow to anger. For your anger does not produce God's righteousness. Therefore, rid yourselves of all sordidness and rank growth of wickedness, and welcome with meekness the implanted word that has the power to save your souls. But be doers of the word, and not merely hearers who deceive themselves. For if any are hearers of the word and not doers, they are like those who look at themselves in a mirror. For they look at themselves and, on going away, immediately forget what they were like. But those who look into the perfect law, the law of liberty, and persevere, being not hearers who forget but doers who act, they will be blessed in their doing. If any think they are religious and do not bridle their tongues but deceive their hearts, their religion is worthless. Religion that is pure and undefiled before God the Father is this: to care for orphans and widows in their distress, and to keep oneself unstained by the world. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please stand.
Hear the Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Now when the Pharisees and some of the scribes who had come from Jerusalem gathered around him, they noticed that some of his disciples were eating with defiled hands, that is, without washing them. For the Pharisees and all the Jews do not eat unless they thoroughly wash their hands, thus observing the tradition of the elders, and they do not eat anything from the market unless they wash it. And there are also many other traditions that they observe, the washing of cups, pots, and bronze kettles. So the Pharisees and the scribes asked him, "Why do your disciples not live according to the tradition of the elders, but eat with defiled hands?" He said to them, "Isaiah prophesied rightly about you, hypocrites, as it is written, 'This people honour me with their lips, but their hearts are far from me. In vain do they worship me, teaching human precepts as doctrines. You abandon the commandment of God and hold to human tradition. Then he called the crowd again and said to them, "Listen to me, all of you, and understand. There is nothing outside a person that by going in can defile. But the things that come out are what defile. For it is from within, from the human heart, that evil intentions come. Fornication, theft, murder, adultery, avarice, wickedness, deceit, licentiousness, envy, slander, pride, folly. All these evil things come from within, and they defile the person." This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
May I speak in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
So, what do you make of the two readings today? They can seem to contradict or clash with each other in some way. The one, the Epistle of James, with the instruction to be doing and giving how to do as well. And the gospel reading, the words of Jesus, talking about not needing to observe the rules and traditions of the Jewish elders, seemingly saying that it's okay to disregard what the elders and wise people of the faith had accumulated over the years, the interpretation in the minute detail of the Old Testament rules, and have become requirements by tradition. You could say it's a bit like, using an example from my past work as a lawyer, how laws are often framed in broad principles, and then through like government guidance and regulation, given more meat. And the precedent of court cases in specific circumstances. This law is very much built around the idea of interpreting what is termed as the mischief the law is meant to cover and how it relates to the particular circumstances. It's why you can have so many lawyers presenting a different view of law on the same circumstances, and you get those contested cases. And in all honesty, situations change. And we've experienced that a lot over this last few months and years, with those rules and laws introduced over the time of this current pandemic. And if we're honest, it's very easy to become literal, specific, without looking to the intent, for want of a better word. In some criminal cases, there is often a requirement for both an action to be done, as well as a mental element. In other words, it's not what you do, it's the way that you do it, as well. But readings today, though, talk about things stemming from the inside, as well as what we do. The manner and the trust, the focus, the commands of God. In our hearts, because we all know that doing things for the sake of it, or even because it's always been done that way, without really thinking it through, or even meaning it, hypocrisy. You can see what Jesus says. As it's trying to manipulate situational commands so that they suit us. Or even just going through the motions. We are called to be obedient to God's word, his commandments. And that word comes from the root, obed, meaning to listen, to be open. Not just hear in one ear and out the other. Or ritual for the sake of it. Or just doing something completely different. But it's for us to listen, to work it through, and let them work it out in our lives. Each and every one of us. And as a church. Like we are trying to do at this time for our church, in the world. We're called to be fed, like we've heard over the last few weeks, allowing the word of God within, the Holy Spirit, to indwell, to be at work within us, and to let that show forth in our lives. How we live, in other words, in thought and word and deed, as it says in some of our church services. If we are witnesses in the world today of God's love through Christ, as it says in the Collect, then we are called to truly reflect that love in our lives. Showing that love and compassion by the grace of God, however unlikely, unworthy we may feel we are. Letting God work within us as we believe and trust in him. I'd like to end with a prayer of St. Teresa of Avila. Christ has no body now but yours, no hands, no feet on earth but yours. Yours are the eyes through which he looks, compassion on this world. Yours are the feet with which he walks to do good. Yours are the hands through which he blesses all the world. Yours are the hands. Yours are the feet. Yours are the eyes. You are his body. Christ has no body now on earth but yours. Amen.
Let us now stand and affirm our faith in God, the faith which, as our baptism, we promise to affirm in our lives. Do you believe and trust in God the Father, source of all being and life, the one for whom we exist?
We believe and
trust in him. Do you believe and trust in God the Son, who took our human nature, died for us and rose again?
We believe and trust in him.
Do you believe and trust in God the Holy Spirit, who gives life to the people of God and makes Christ known in the world?
We believe and trust in him.
faith of the Church.
This is our faith.
We believe and trust in one God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Now, in union with Christ and in the power of the Spirit, let us pray to the Father. Please sit on the for our prayers.
The knowledge that Christians have worshipped you for 2,000 years, inspired by revival. This knowledge is a source of strength and a very present help in time of trouble. But you are also the living water from the well of heaven, the bread of life that must be renewed each day. Creator God, we thank you for bringing us to the beginning of this new day. And we thank you for all it brings, for the sunshine and the rain and the bounty it brings forth from the earth. We pray for all who have no access to food or clean fresh water due to poverty or climate change. Praying especially for the people of Haiti, who have lost so much in the earthquake, and for Greece, Turkey, and California, who continue to battle with wildfires. Lord God, may you grant them and all of us the courage and perseverance to tackle both the immediate problem and its causes. Lord, in your mercy,
amen.
We pray for your whole creation, for brothers and sisters throughout the world, and for their lives to be respected and revered, regardless of color, creed, culture, gender, wealth, or status. Let it never be forgotten that it is you, our God, King of Kings, who is ruler of all. Lord, in your mercy. Heavenly Father, we pray for Queen Elizabeth, the head of the Church. We pray for the Church here in St. Anne's and all around the world, that it may become a sign of hope and a beacon of light in darkness. May God grant us all the courage to bring light to those who are afraid or suffering. We pray for leaders. We pray for world leaders, that God might grant them the wisdom to make just decisions that lead to peace, and the compassion to take practical action for those in most need. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
Following our weekly prayer diary, we include in our prayers all those who live in Stratford Road and Shepherd Road. And we also ask for your blessing on our No Doubt magazine team and website team. And we also pray for all who go out to work in our community, all who work from home, all who are starting a new job. May they find lasting fulfillment and blessing. We pray for those who feel overwhelmed by worry and stress at this time, who are in debt or out of work, those who harbour guilt, regret, or unforgiveness in their hearts. May their burdens be lifted and their souls refreshed. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
And young people as they prepare to go back to the classroom, praying that they have had a good summer break and that they are rested. We pray for children and young people around the world, especially those whose homes are not places of safety, those children who are isolated, and those who are afraid. We pray for the elderly, especially those who feel vulnerable and weighed down by the aches and pains of old age. We pray they, young and old, receive loving care and support, and may we reach out and truly care for each other through our actions, as well as our words. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
Lord, we thank you for the gift of friendship, of family. Help us not to forget that we have two ears and only one tongue, that it is more blessed to listen than to be listened to. Help us show forbearance of one another's flaws, knowing that we have flaws and imperfections of our own. Let us be slow to anger and quick to forgive. Lord, in your mercy. And so we continue to pray for those in our society who minister to the needs of others. We pray for the medical staff, key workers around the world, as they face the immense challenge of this global pandemic. We think of the caring professions, emergency services. We think of the host of aid and relief agencies working for charities and good causes. God of love, we thank you for all who minister to the needs of others. Inspire us through their example, equip them in their continuing efforts, and enrich the lives of many through the service they offer. Lord, in your mercy. Lord, you see the pain of the whole world. We pray for all who are experiencing the terror of war, violence and conflict, for widows and orphans struggling alone. We pray particularly for those who are forced to flee their home in fear, praying especially for the people of We pray, Lord, that they find open doors, open minds, and open hearts wherever they seek shelter and peace. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
In the silence of our hearts, we lift to you all those who are unwell, in body, mind, or spirit, for those on our church prayer list, for those on our hearts this morning who we are particularly concerned for, remembering each person is precious and cherished by God, not just a number. Lord, may they be healed by your presence and your love. And Lord, we thank you for those whom you have healed and those on the road to recovery. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
We pray for all those who have died, for those who have died this past night, those who have died recently, and those whose anniversaries occur at this time. We give thanks for those whose earthly journey is over and now rest in peace in your loving care. May your loving and healing arms comfort and strengthen those who are mourning the death of a loved one at this time, and for all who are missing someone special and dear. May God bring the light of hope and the comfort of his love into their hearts. And may we all one day be reunited in the glory of your heaven. Merciful Father,
accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Please stand. We are the body of Christ. In the one Spirit we were all baptized into one body. Let us then pursue all that makes a peace and builds up our common life. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Let's offer one another suitably distanced sign of peace. You may wish to sit as we prepare the altar. Lord is here.
The Spirit is with us.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let's give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks and praise.
Father, we give you thanks and praise through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your living Word, through whom you have created all things, who was sent by you in your great goodness to be our Savior. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he took flesh. As your Son, born of the Blessed Virgin, he lived on earth and went about among us. He opened wide his arms for us on the cross. He put an end to death by dying for us, and revealed the resurrection by rising to new life. So he fulfilled your will, and won for you a holy people. Therefore, with angels and archangels, with all the company of heaven, we proclaim your great and glorious name, forever praising you and saying,
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Lord, you are holy indeed, the source of all holiness. Grant that by the power of your Holy Spirit and according to your holy will, these gifts of bread and wine may be to us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, who in the same night was betrayed, took bread, gave you thanks. He broke it and gave it his disciples, saying, Take, eat. This is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. In the same way, after supper, he took the cup and gave you thanks. He gave it to them, saying, Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me. Great is the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. So, Father, calling to mind his death on the cross, his perfect sacrifice made once for sins of the whole world, rejoicing in his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, and looking for his coming in glory, we celebrate this memorial of our redemption. As we offer you this, our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, we bring before you this bread and this cup, and we thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and serve. Send the Holy Spirit on your people, and gather into one in your kingdom all who share this one bread and one cup, so that we, in the company of Thomas, Bartholomew, and of all the saints, may praise and glorify you forever, through Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom and with whom and in whom, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory be yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
Sit or kneel for the Lord. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever. We pray. Lamb of God, have mercy on us. Jesus, bearer of our sins, have mercy on us. Jesus, redeemer of the world, grant us peace. Jesus is the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world. Blessed are those who are called for his Son.
Lord, I am not worthy to receive you, but only
say the word, and I shall. These holy mysteries, not only to my own benefit, but on behalf of those who watch online, all those who share in this sacrament cannot.
Amen.
Christ, who has nourished us with himself, the living bread, make you one in praise of love, and raise you up at the last day. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you and remain with you, now and always.
Amen.
Go in peace to love, serve the Lord.
In the name of Christ.
Closing hymn is number 17, Be Thou My Vision, number 17.
Ha, ha, ha.